Situated at Levi's Stadium. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Miami Dolphins and the San Francisco 49ers. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at these 49ers as they interplay here. They come in losers of two straight, so they're trying to right the ship here a little bit.
They're teetering a little bit, aren't they? And now things could really go south if they lose this game, so they understand the importance of playing.
Taken about a yard deep and beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. So here come the Dolphins now as they get set to take over on offense. They are led out by their 27-year-old quarterback, a two-time Pro Bowler. It's Dak Prescott.
I like this guy. And the reason I do, he tends to stay on an even keel. Doesn't let too much ruffle him. He will manage the game the way it needs to be managed, take what the defense gives him, and then he can strike at times. Had a touchdown pass. Yes, he had an interception last week, but he found a way for his team to win.
He gets it forward for four, maybe five, but the flags fly, and this one could be coming back.
You gotta be smarter than that, man. Come on.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. That to his running back, Edwards-Helaire. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down.
6 yard pickup. Brings up second down.
They'll run for the first time with Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. On 3rd down, it's Prescott. He's got the tight end, Vanette. And the ball is knocked out. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. So here the 49ers and their offense in great field position already. And they'll be led out by a second-round pick back in April out of Oklahoma by way of Alabama. It's Jalen Hurts.
Would you say that last week's performance by him, workmanlike in terms of numbers?
One touchdown, one pick, but obviously a loss.
Yeah, and that's the bottom line for him. All he cares about is how do we find a way to win the game. Maybe leans on a few other parts of the offense and hopefully springs a receiver or two free.
Jabril Peppers deep to receive. Powers through. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Niners will go on offense. First and 10. San Francisco set to go on offense once more. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll start with the option.
The pass.
It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and that'll make it second down.
1 yard gain brings up second and 9.
From the gun, it's Hurts. And now he'll tuck it and run. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down.
On the tackle. It's a gain of 3. Brings up 3rd and 6.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Josh Allen drops him for a loss of 10, and it's going to be 4th and long.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. So on 4th down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Fielded at about the 28. So a solid punt, but also a nice return there of 14 yards. And it'll be Dolphin football. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. 2 drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
That was well played there defensively. 2 tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11. Prescott from the gun. In trouble, and he's taken down.
Leonard Williams
just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Well, there was 2nd long. Now it's 3rd and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Prescott, and he's got his man in stride, complete.
Prescott's pass.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Just a 5-yard pickup, but it leads to 4th down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. Returning is Peppers. 35 yards that time on the punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. Back out there comes the 49ers offense ready for their second drive. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out with a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go. Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody he just snuck out there and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. On first and 10, it's Hurts. Left side here to Sanders. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. That catch good for only a couple.
Brings up second and 8 at their 48-yard line.
Second down, here's Hurts. This short throw caught by Goddard. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Here's Hurts to throw. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
The drive will begin with a run by Edwards-Helaire. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Defensively, he has been a presence in their backfield in the first half. Had a sack earlier, and now he comes up with a big tackle for a loss.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Now Prescott, and his pass incomplete. Hayden Hurst, former first-round pick, the intended target, and it'll bring up third down. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And he'll look underneath here for Edwards-Helaire, and he gets it up to the 10-yard line here. 3 yards all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he's on to punt for Miami. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the Niners set up well. They take over first and 10 on the short side of the field. And San Francisco gets set to go here.
It's their third drive now, and so far we've seen a punt. In that second drive, CD, they turned the ball over, so not the start that they were envisioning.
Yeah, they've been ineffective so far, but look, they've worked on a game plan all week long. Don't get away from it too soon. Find a way to get some significant gains, loosen up, get going, and then they should be okay the rest of the way.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
Second and 12 now at the 44-yard line. Hurts sets up to throw it. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones.
Hurts pass.
It's a gain of five on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Jones with a carry on first down, but I don't think he even made it back to the line of scrimmage as the defense all over that one. The defense was ready for the run pass option, diagnosed it perfectly.
Not only did they stack him up at the point of attack, but he was met by a host of light-colored jerseys.
Second and 11 now. Throwing is Hurts. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So that's now four completions in a row, a good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13.
He was brought down at the
13. We're scoreless after one.
That's the end of the first quarter with no score.
The 49ers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got a second and eight forthcoming. This is Jones. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Aaron Jones, his third touchdown now on the year, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. And the 49ers grab a 7-0 lead. So that drive takes them down the field in eight plays. And the last play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. From the six. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own.
Now Cortland Sutton and the rest of the offense getting ready for their next drive. You better believe that he's well aware he has zero catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware as well, and they're really excited he has no catches, but they're also worried, because a lot of times it's like the ticking time bomb. The longer you hold him down, when he finally explodes, look out.
Yeah, no catches, though, so far this game. Tackle there by Alex Anzalone.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and 7 at the 26-yard line.
On second and 7, Prescott. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end.
Prescott.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First down, Miami.
Prescott down. And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. A gain of 6 there on first. They'll come up on a second and 4 now from the 40-yard line.
It's a pickup of 6. brings up second.
They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Edwards-Helaire. And he's got this one across midfield into 49er territory. Avery Williamson there to make the stop.
Avery Williamson.
On second down, a run with Edwards-Helaire. And he'll get this down only to about the 46.
He was tackled at the 46-yard line. It's a gain of a yard.
Prescott from the gun on third. Buying time to his left. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 8 yards that time, able to take off, and the result is a first down.
We have so many different terms for third down, third and short, third and long, third and manageable. How about third and medium? Because that's what this one was. The defense looked like they had him hemmed in, but he gets away, evades the rush, and picks up just enough for the first down.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll try to throw now. Prescott over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was going for the tight end, Nick Vanette. That'll bring up second down.
It's second down and 10.
Prescott. They set up the screen to Penny. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. Now that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize that it's broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
And that is incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want. Anytime they want to throw the football, there was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
It is no good. That keeps the score 9-7. Dolphins nothing.
Jones in the offense trotting back out. We're in the second quarter. They got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes to find later.
Yeah, try to get him more involved here on this drive, maybe.
A 3-yard pickup. Brings up second and
from the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. The left side completion to Jones. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Now a draw play. This is Jones. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. He's just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Brings up second and 9.
Hurts. He gets it left side to Johnson. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 24-yard line. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. On first down, it's Jones. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there.
The ball carrier.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
It's a pickup of three.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but not a heck of a lot more than that throughout this game.
No, not at all. In fact, I would say that this defense has done as good of a job on him as they have on any runner in recent memory.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete.
Hurts.
And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one.
A gain of a yard.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play.
And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. The sack by Harold Landry, the former Boston College Eagle.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean,
Chris Boswell.
Oftentimes, the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
45-yard attempt.
And this one is right down Broadway.
The kick in.
And the lead moves to 10-0.
Makes the score Niners 10, Dolphins nothing.
So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get three of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue because, you know, after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get three? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
27-yard
line. Now Cortland Sutton and the rest of the offense getting ready for their next drive. They've got to be thinking, how can we get him a little bit more involved here? Second quarter, you're down, and really, he's been out of the mix.
I would agree with that, and oftentimes you hear, well, we're just taking what the defense is giving us, but sometimes that's just not good enough. Sometimes you have to take what you want, and that means getting him the football.
Yeah, so far just a single catch in this game. Give him nine there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one.
36-yard line.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Montez Sweat able to drop him for a loss of a couple.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
The Dolphins on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This time it's third and three. Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
It's a gain of six. And the Dolphin first down.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. 10-0, our score. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
They'll contain him to just four, second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and you can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down. And he's unable to haul it in, so it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up fourth.
It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And the 49ers will take over deep in their own territory. Out comes Calvin Ridley and the offense for their next drive. Second quarter, a guy like him, no catches, so that's the surprising part. But they're winning, so maybe they've been able to do some other things effectively, I guess.
And they found other ways, haven't they? Because the receivers would tell you, offense needs to run through us. But they're managing to get it done in this ball game without having to actually do that. I wouldn't expect them to stay silent for the rest of the game.
Yeah, you got to think that his first catch is coming. Taking it right down Broadway. Touchdown, 49ers. Calvin Ridley, 88 yards. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. That pass also evens the ledger for the rookie quarterback. Had the interception earlier, and now he gets the touchdown throw.
The ideal touchdown-interception ratio is, what, 3-1 for the best quarterbacks? But he's a rookie. Just getting back to even is a big deal. Increases the confidence his teammates have in him as he tries to become their leader.
He's got it, and it's 17-0. Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. From the six. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
The Dolphins take over first and 10. At their own 27.
The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. And in a spot like this, still more than a minute, I think if you put something on the board before halftime, that would go a long way towards helping them get back into the game.
There actually is something to the psychology of the game at times, isn't there? How much better would they feel running into the locker room, as you noted, with something on the board in a positive fashion? You're exactly right. It's a great opportunity to get that done. This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
On second down, Prescott again. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire.
Prescott.
5 yards. Now it's third and five. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. A pass for Sutton is intercepted. Taylor Rapp with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
You're trailing, you're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side with that good field position they just took over with. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Calvin Ridley, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead. Extra point now by Boswell. And the lead is now 24. Well, the offense wasn't out there for a long time, but they were out there for a good time. One play, and they're able to hit pay dirt. Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. From the six. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
Penny on the return. The Dolphins take over first and 10. At their own.
Miami set to take over. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But there's also something to challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. He'll swing this one out to Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. On first and 10, Prescott. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Smith. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
First down, Miami.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. And they get a little bit closer here as the lead's down to three touchdowns. So a big play before the end of the half to get them into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
So time perhaps for one final kneel down before they take this lead to the locker room. And with time running down, they go down to a knee. The white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report.
All right, Brandon, we'll get back to you guys in a bit. But first, let's take a look around the NFL here on this first Sunday of October. We'll begin our tour up at First Energy Stadium in Cleveland. And it's the Browns who have the lead in the second quarter. Lamar Jackson has thrown a touchdown pass. From there, we're off to check out another game. And they were victorious in that one over the visiting Jacksonville Jaguars. Kirk Cousins leading the way in the victory with three touchdown passes. Meanwhile, our game has been a boat race, very one-sided to this point. And for the call of the second half, let's get it back to our commentating team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. Out comes Calvin Ridley and the offense for their next drive. And these highlights here showcasing the solid game he's had.
Well, someone woke up and felt good about themselves then, didn't they? I have to feel that he came into this one with the idea that, yeah, I can do this. Whether it's preparation, reading the film, whatever it was, it's paying off in a big way as we watch this one unfold.
Yeah, two touchdowns, over 100 yards already. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Here's a second and two now from the 33. They'll run it with Jones. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the gun, it's Hurts. This short throw caught by Goddard. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 15 for the Niners there and a first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
First down, Hurts, and he'll find Moreau here. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And on the catch, right side, this is Sanders. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first.
First and 10 at the 32-yard line.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. He'll drop this underneath for Jones. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
A gain of 9 brings up second and 1. At the 23-yard line.
Second down. Here's Hurts. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30.
By Josh Allen. A 7-yard loss.
Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Here's Hurts to throw. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
Makes the score Niners 27, Dolphins 3.
So put another 3 on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
At their own 20.
So here are the Dolphins now. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football.
And a loose football.
Prescott's pass complete to Hayden Hurst.
Fumble. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about since training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Traquan Smith, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
Chris Harris on the coverage.
Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. Being chased out left. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. That to his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
They certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Prescott from the gun. Smith catches left side. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Off the play fake, Prescott. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Second and 10 here as we roll along in quarter number 3 from Santa Clara. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. 3 yards all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Kowski on for the field goal. A 36-yard attempt.
And Gostkowski's kick is good. And they get a little bit closer here as the lead's down to 3 touchdowns.
Dolphins 6.
So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point's not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
Out comes Calvin Ridley and the offense for their next drive. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Now, pass complete here to Sanders. Call that a gain of 5 as the clock ticks inside and 2 minutes to go now in the third.
That's a gain of 5. Brings up 3rd and 1.
On 3rd and short, they'll try option left. And he's going to go backwards. They get him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to make it 4th down.
Just a simple run play there on 3rd and 1, but this D was up to the challenge and stopped him, bringing up 4th down.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. 42 yards on the punt, just 2 on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Dolphins ready to take over on offense. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
First down, Dolphins.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating
what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there. You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
17 yards.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 49-yard line. They'll throw again. Prescott looking middle, and it's incomplete. Cortland Sutton, first-time Pro Bowler, he was the intended target, but it'll be second down. A second down throw for Prescott. Over the middle to Smith. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 33. Back now here in Santa Clara. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Prescott yet again, able to hit his target, Claypool. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. 7 yards to pick up there.
Second and 3 at the 40.
Looking to throw again on second down. Prescott, and he'll look underneath here for Edwards-Helaire. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1.
A gain of 2 on the play. And this is third.
And again, it's Prescott. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down. To the air again, Prescott. To the right side and complete to Hurst. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done.
And the Dolphin first down.
They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire. Showed off the toughness, but still corralled shy of the 5 at the 6. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
A 7-yard pickup.
Play action now. Prescott. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. The Dolphins on third down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. Here it's 3rd and 3. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. A field goal does you no good, so they're going to stay out there and go for it on fourth. They'll go. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he's not even going to come close to picking up the first. They stop him right at the line of scrimmage. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And the 49ers are going to get the football back. And they've now made 2 trips to the red zone and still looking for their first touchdown.
Not able to punch it in, and if you're on defense, your confidence is sky high. Because mentally, you're saying, hey, if you're in the red zone, we're thinking we're giving up 3, we just want to give up 6. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown at all. They've got to feel great about what they got done.
And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down. Another example of this offense really having their way, Charles, and another big chunk play there on the ground.
And when you look at the defense, they've got to do a much better job of wrapping up when they tackle. A lot of great opportunities continue to slip through their fingers, as do the runners.
After the run by Jones, here's 1st and 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones. And he'll get this up to about the 40.
Jones, the ball carrier.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Brings up second and five.
Here's Jones. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of five.
On the carry.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Steps away, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Sack. A 4 yard
Brandon,
ball.
More often than not, you'd say they've had his number, and we can count them up so far. 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks given up. But guess what? He's still been able to make some plays, and right now they have a lead.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. We'll call that a 43-yard punt, 2 on the return. And the Dolphins' drive will start deep in their own territory with a first and 10. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Prescott on the crossing route, complete. It's Smith. A gain of 6 there on first. So second and 4 from the 22.
6-yard pickup brings up second and 4 at the 22-yard line.
To throw is Prescott. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. The rookie Jordan Brooks picks it off. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
First and 10 and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18.
The ball carrier.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8 at the 18-yard line.
On the jet sweep, this is Johnson. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
It's now third and 9.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. The decision to tuck and run gets him 3, but that's not enough. Now it's 4th.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Boswell's kick is good, and that will extend the lead out to 24.
Dolphins 6.
So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Dolphins' offense now ready to go back out onto the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that, and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team, and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
The catch and run there. Good for 16 and a first. He'll swing this one out to Edwards-Helaire. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
Second and six.
And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 27-yard line. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. Flush to his right. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
At the 21-yard line. It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
Here's Prescott. And they're going to get him. He sagged back around the 28. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game. Third down, it's Prescott. And Prescott, his third interception. Levi Wallace with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
First and 10 at their own 11-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They're in control here as they start first and 10 and appearing to have righted the ship following that two-game losing streak. A run there on first down and a pretty good one of 5 yards, so make it second and five.
The ball carrier.
So the victory here for San Francisco, and I think the game balls need to be distributed on the defensive side of the football, and I bet that you would agree.
Yeah, if you hold a team under 10 points, that's a job well done, really well done. So I would say game balls for every starter and every key player who participated in this game.
Now, see, I only like one game ball.
You just like
you're
one
handing
game
out,
ball?
You're handing out multiple, although I set you up by saying game balls plural.
Yeah,
but,
yeah, I like where we're going with this, though. You say one to represent,
yeah,
like the best player of all,
yeah,
of that. And I say multiples so that you keep everyone motivated and involved.
You're a man of the people.
I'm a man of the people. I thought I was the only child.
You
yes,
get
like
a game ball,
child.
And you get a game ball. Game balls for everybody.
So for the 49ers, it'll be a 500 start as the win gets them back to 2-2. And they'll have another home date next week as the L.A. Rams come to town. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And they'll look to get back on track next week as they travel to Denver to take on the Broncos.